Islam and national security have been in the news significantly. We've come into a situation where we've decided to, you know, trade off a lot of liberty in exchange for safety. And I think we need to question some of these things. Is it necessary? There is a threat of terrorism, but how do we deal with it within the confines of the Constitution? That is what, you know, I like to explore and I like to discuss with my students. What needs to happen in the next little while is work in two fronts. One is in the Islamic area or in the Muslim community area, it's necessary for scholars and jurists and religious leaders to educate the Muslim masses about the fact that extremists have hijacked Islam. In the non-Muslim community, what we need to do is stand up for the Constitution. Yes, dissent is allowed. Possibly even extremism is allowed. Interpretations, because freedom of expression and freedom is vital for our society to continue. But when they cross the line into violence or promoting violence, yes, we need to come down hard on it. So if you really want to fight this war, then you need to have the Muslims on board. And that means, you know, building trust. The community has to be able to trust the government, and the government has to be able to trust the Muslim community. So there's work that needs to be done in both camps. And I see my role as trying to explain and explicate Islamic law, but also national security, how to bridge the two, and how it's not necessary to give up liberty in order to protect our freedoms.